Hi folks, I'm David Kwan here. I've been meaning to talk about this since a long time ago, but I am ashamed to admit there was a time in my life like last year when I was constantly updating or going to Clash of Clans. Like, I was really addicted to this thing, and it's one of those things where, I don't know, it's not really fun. It's kind of like Simpsons Tapped Out, or Farmville, or any of those kind of things, where you just do it, just because it's just kind of like, okay, I can go in, I can tap some stuff, gather resources, and do some things here, and then, okay, now I'm done with what I have to do, I'm locked out of time, so I'll just do something else, and you just wait, and then, you know, my iPad, I just use my iPad for this, it pops up, oh yeah, all your troops are now healed, or you just go back and you see that I have more resources or whatever. So it's like play for, it's a weird game concept. Like, I play for a minute and then it's not even really playing. I'm just tapping on different resources making sure I build a base, I gather all the resources and I train the troops. Once I have enough troops, I can go ahead and attack single player stuff. Clash of Clans is not really all that fun battle, you know, gameplay-wise. You just tap the soldiers wherever you're going to make them enter, and then you just watch it unfold and how it happens. There's no strategy involved on what the soldiers are going to attack or how they're going to attack. You just place them, and they just do their thing, and you just watch. This is like the most weird real-time strategy game there ever was, because there's no strategy other than you just build the units, and you place them there, and you hope for the best. Until single player kind of gets to a point where it's impossible to beat without getting really significant upgrades, you know, or level. You have to upgrade your town. In doing so, requires a lot of resources, and a lot of resources means waiting a lot of time, or spending real money to buy those gems that can speed up your time and also buy resources, which I have not done for Clash of Clans. Clash of Clans, I am ashamed to say, I played for, I don't know, or been really hooked on. It's like a job. Like, this is not like a game I play for fun. It's more like, it's like an obligation. Oh yeah, now it's time to build, now it's time to gather resources. So weird how that worked. I don't know how I got hooked into it. But I mean, I really do. There's a lot of charming aspects to Clash of Clans. I think there's a reason why it has become such a gigantic popular monster. And it's one of the most, I think it's made so much money for the developers behind that game, that they were able to make a sequel that's making them just as much money now. Boom Beach, which I will talk about. I didn't play Boom Beach as much. I think I got way suckered into Clash of Clans. It's charming though. The graphics are really charming. I really like the whole 3D graphics. The cartoon characters, you have the warrior, the female archer, the wizard. I never got to the point where I can have walls that are purple. Those like super purple walls, and I didn't really get to that level. But I did get to a level where, you know, they upgrade, you know, there was a major update in which clan wars were introduced. So I did join a clan, and we did periodically engage in these clan wars with other people. And that was really interesting. And I got, you know, like I said, I was patient with this game for a long time, repeatedly going in. And there came a point where I would start to build something, and it would say, it would take 3 days for this to finish building. I'm just like, 3 days, oh my god. And I gathered enough green gems, 500, to able to buy another worker. So I could build 3 things at a time, instead of having to wait so long. So yeah, I actually played this too, so much. But I never got beyond the point where I'm just like, you know, oh, I'm so powerful, I have a dragon, I have these bull riders, you know, the only black characters in the game, angels, flying angels who can heal your units. The game gets really interesting, like, way you level up. But to get to that point, I would have to spend so much real life money, which I was not willing to do for a game that is not fun to play. That's kind of my philosophy. If this game is not fun to play, I shouldn't spend money on it, you know? And it's just kind of just suckered me into it. I was really tempted to pay money to get it, but it just costs so much money. Paying $5 will barely get you anything in this game. Like, I think, you know, you need 500 gems for another worker or something like that. And, man, it's just, this game is expensive. You have to spend, like, $50 to get really anywhere. And, for a game like this, I am not willing to spend $50. And I think that's why it's one of the most top-grossing games on the Apple Store, just because it's so expensive to be able to really get far and to get to the level where you're, like, actually really beating people high level and ranking up. And so it's an interesting concept. Now, Boom Beach, it kind of takes the same kind of similar gameplay concept of you get to build your own base, you get to defend your base from incoming enemy players when you're offline, and you get to attack other human enemy bases when they're offline and you're online. So same interesting concept here. You have a lot of units, you get to level up units. But Boom Beach, I gave up really quickly. So there are two things about Boom Beach that I actually really like. One is you get to able to kind of, after you deploy your battle units, you can actually retreat. You can send them where to go by, like, you know, saying you tap on the ship, the artillery ship, and then you direct them where to go. And it costs action points to do that. And it gets increasingly more expensive the more you do it, which I think is a great concept. So this game, the gameplay actually is fun. There actually is some strategy to this game, which is great. So that makes me more involved. But it's less charming. The units are more generic. And all the characters in this game, there's no black character in this game, which I found really odd, just because it's you know, but it's the World War II setting. There's ranged weapons. There's ways to play in the game, and there's more defense kind of units. And you are limited. The ways the enemies can attack is by, you know, with the ships two sides. So there's way more defense options. You can set up mines. I mean, gameplay wise, it's a much more interesting game. It's more dynamic. The way you can kind of explore out and tap on the unforeseen islands, and when you unlock islands, you have certain boss enemies, boss bases to go to. The way it integrates single player campaign with the human multi. Anyway, it does a lot of stuff right. What I don't like, it locks you out of the gameplay really quickly. It gets to a point where it's like, oh, I have to spend real money to actually get far. Like, that happens super early in this game. Clash of Clans, that does not happen until, like, way late in the end cycle. And by that point, like, you spend so much time with the game that I feel like, okay, I feel guilty if I don't pay money to kind of support the developer. The only reason I didn't pay was just because it wasn't like a fun game. It was more like I felt like I was suckered into, like, being addicted into it. Like, it was like a gambling addiction or something. And I was like, I have to quit because this is like, I'm not enjoying this. I'm just kind of suckered into it. Where Boom Beach was fun, but there's a point where you level up your headquarters to level 3. Now, to level up to level 4, you need this amount of resources. Here's the thing. You can't just wait and have enough of those resources. Those resources you can't gain, but you can only do it by winning battles and doing something like that. So, but you can't win battles because now your enemies are so much more difficult, so you need more advanced units. You can only get these advanced units with a certain amount of resources. You can't get those resources by gathering them. So the best way to get those resources is to spend real-life money to buy those resources. That's how, like, where Boom Beach just kind of gets like, okay, I see what they're trying to do. They're really trying to really get that money out of me, because they, you know, it's a free-to-play game, but they gotta make money. The developers gotta do it. But it's kind of frustrating how they do it. And also, again, Boom Beach is super expensive. It's not really affordable for me. It's so you know, that just made me like realize like, okay, and it doesn't have the same charm. It's just kind of the Gatling gun guy, rifleman guy, and the progression is really slow. I think Boombeast is really guilty of wanting that real life money from you, so it just kind of locks you out of the experience really quick. And so it made me realize like, you know, this is I'm not gonna be suckered into paying real life money to continue playing this game, which I'm not really getting that much enjoyment out of, you know. I mean, it's more fun than Clash of Clans, but Clash of Clans has a lot more deeply layered game in terms of the whole scope of the game. There's clan wars, there's all these other things. The gameplay itself might not be fun, but the entire scope of that game, I think, is more layered. But again, Clash of Clans is an older game. It has a lot more updates. So I guess Boombeast going forward is probably going to be updated a lot to the point where it gets really nuanced and really complex. And so that's one of these great things about mobile games. They constantly update where, you know, like you go back to it and it's just like, wow, this game has changed so much. I recently went back into Sonic Dash, right? That's a game that I bought for $2.99 when it first came out. Now it's free to play, and there are ways to kind of pay into the thing for more benefits, whatever. And so Sonic Dash was one of those things that was like, okay, this is really cool. It kind of got old. I went back to it like months later. They added in boss fights. They added in a new stage. And it's just like, wow. Like, it keeps improving itself. Asphalt 8. That game, I actually spent quite a bit of money on that game just because I was so impressed. I had so much fun. I wanted to support the developer. That game, like, I think I could go back to it now. It's just a huge file. My iPad is only 16 gigabytes, so there's a limited amount of space, so I tend to just kind of delete it. Asphalt 8 is huge. You know, Asphalt 8 is like freaking 1.8 gigabytes or something like that. It's just an insane file size. But I think, you know, if I re-download that into my iPad, I'm just going to be surprised. Like, oh, there are these new cars, there's these new tracks, there's these new features. So it's constantly amazing to me how these iPhone, iPad games constantly update themselves. And they feel like more new experiences added on, even without paying for them. DLC happens in the mobile world without paying for DLC. It's the other stuff that's monetized. Some games do it really properly. But some games, like Boombeast, just like, no, I'm not going to fall into the free-to-win kind of scheme that's going on here. I'm too smart for this, so I quit. And so Clash of Clans and Boombeast, that's kind of my experience. I can definitely understand how they can kind of suck you in a way, even though they're not really games in the more traditional game sense. Even like a pretty hardcore gamer like myself can get into really like the casual gaming experience on the iPad and iPhone. Even I'm susceptible to that. And yeah. But I mean, I think with Clash of Clans, I think there's a lot of charm in there. Just the graphic and art style to it. Boombeast is just more generic. It's more fun gameplay wise, but the charm doesn't. I think charm is important in the longevity of these games. To keep you going back, the charm has to be there, and Boombeast doesn't have that. Like Simpsons Tapped Out, I think that's one of those games where it's really charming because you're able to kind of, you know, Simpsons. You're like they did a really good homage to that TV series. So that's also one of those games that I was like 2 years ago or 3 years ago that I also was pretty addicted to. And Tiny Towers was another thing. And there are these games out there that's just like, it's really, really interesting to get into. You're not really, it doesn't really feel like you're playing them or anything, but I just found them pretty interesting. But yeah, those are my experiences with these. I don't know, there's this genre of games where you build bases and you're able to attack other people's bases when they're offline, and they can attack you when you're offline, and you have to build your defenses, but the defenses, the troops that you raise are not able to defend your base. Only the defensive towers and arch, you know, turrets and mines can defend your base. Yeah, but that's this genre in a nutshell. The goal of the developers of this genre is to make it so that you hit a certain point where you're gonna need a lot of resources, And the best way to get those resources, and the least annoying way to do that is to pay real life money to get gems to buy resources. That's the way developers gotta make money on these things. And so I think Clash of Clans, if they were priced more reasonably, I would have been okay. Boom Beach is just too—it's too obvious what they're trying to do, and I'm not for that. Way too early in the game that it becomes way too hard until you pay real life money, and I was just really bothered by that. But yeah, this was it. I talked a lot about these two games, maybe a little too much, but yeah. Hope you guys enjoyed. Cheers.